No pics, but it still happened. Today I am releasing new merch. I feel like I should show you it because it's like, it's releasing right now. Let me go get it. Hold on real quick. Okay, here it is. I like to tie mine like this. You guys probably see I tie a lot of my shirts like this. But, oh god, well it looks stupid with the sports bra underneath. I was really nervous to make something new ever since, like, I Feel Weird and Wee Woo, just cause I know how much you guys did like I Feel Weird, so I was like, shit, I really gotta live up to this. I loved I Feel Weird so much. Like, the second I came up with that, I was like, this is it. Like, this is, I love it. The thread is like, sorry, it's wrinkly, I just took it out of the package, but it's like a blue denim thread. So there's actually some texture to the letters, it's not just black thread. Can't really see it in the camera too much, so you'll have to see it when you get yours. I've noticed for the past couple years, like especially going to any concert or festival or anything, you look around and everybody's just like phones in the air instead of like eyes at the stage. I sound like such a stupid like hipster, but it's true. So I thought this was really cool, just especially for our generation and life as we know it, regardless of your generation. Everybody is on the phone, everybody's on social media. I mean, look at my job, look at all the other creators you watch, look at their jobs. And I just think it's time to slow down whenever you can and just like be present. My mind like almost forgets monumental things that happen in my life because I don't ever allow myself to be present. I'm always thinking about what I have to do that night or the next day or what's more important that I need to be doing. I thought this was kind of like a cool thing to release because it's relevant to what I'm going through right now. So I'm editing my video right now and I filmed this on a plane, as you could probably tell by the title. You know how planes are like really loud, they're like the whole time you're on it? That was my issue, so I have to voice over this whole video, so this will be fun. A lot of you guys have been asking like, drop your skincare routine. This is my skincare routine, but I'm doing it on a plane because I thought, I don't know, I had to wash my face and I had a camera, so I put two and two together and here's my skincare routine. Okay, so this bathroom was so small, you guys. Like, here's an idea so you can kind of gauge how big the bathroom is. I'm telling you, the sink was literally the size of a bag of Doritos, like a fun size bag of Doritos. Getting out my face wash right now, I put it in a bag because I couldn't bring it on carry-on because it's too big and it exploded everywhere, but it smells like oranges, so I'm kind of okay with it. Also brought some Lysol wipes because I heard how gross bathrooms were on the airplane. So I brought those to wipe down everything so that I didn't get staph infection on my face. Here's two cups of water that the flight attendant gave me. She told me to wash my face with this instead of the water in the actual plane, so kind of had to like trial and error this, like tried to pour it on my face, but then it ran down my neck, down my shirt. I ended up just like dipping my hand in it and then like scrubbing my face, and that actually worked. Ooh, okay, I got really innovative here and I got really excited. So inside of the bag, use the face wash like that, use the bag as like a little exfoliator. It worked so well. My face wash, it comes out as foam, so it was hard to be able to like scoop it out and put it in my hand because it was like so sudsy. So this actually worked out, and I feel like I would use this again if I ever needed like one dose of face wash on the go. Okay, so rinsing it off was kind of hard. I feel like I did have a little bit of suds left over, but I got most of it off. Okay, now I'm drying my skin. I'm cringing watching this because I'm literally tugging on my, actually I was tapping, but I'm using paper towels and that freaks me out. I had to do what I had to do though. Like, I literally had no other way to dry my skin, but usually I pat very lightly with a towel. You have to pat lightly, guys. If you tug with your towel, it pulls on your skin, you get wrinkles, and it's just not good to do that. Always pat dry. Okay, so next, it was like 1:30 a.m., so I technically was doing my nighttime routine, even though it was like morning. I don't know, it was nighttime for me. It acts as like an exfoliator. It's not textured in any way. It's absolutely just like serum textured, just like liquid. But the like acids in it, I guess, like eat up the dead cells. I don't know. I'm normally afraid of acids because I break out so easily, or not break out, I react so negatively to like the normal acne agents. Get a really bad allergic reaction to them. Like, my skin will literally start peeling off if I am exposed to the sun. But this one I found is like really safe for my skin. So I just pat it in. Okay, so now this is under eye cream. It's in a sample form from Sephora. I have been looking for an under eye nighttime cream for so long. I think this is the one I'm gonna go with. This is the Alginist. To be honest, I don't know if I've seen a difference yet because I haven't been using it long enough. But the reason I like it is because all other eye creams I've found, they like make, you know, those little like white bumps you get under, there's a name for it. You get they get them under your eye. I got them from like three different eye creams I tried, and sometimes eye creams will like burn my skin there because it's such sensitive skin. But this one I feel like I like a lot, and I just kind of put it everywhere. They said it's safe enough to put on the actual lid itself, and some eye creams aren't. So whatever eye cream you're using, make sure it's safe enough, because I don't know. Okay, this is rose water. This isn't part of my skincare routine daily and nightly, but since I'm on a plane, the moisture is just like literally sucked out of my skin. So I added this in to kind of tone after I put the serum. I don't know if you're supposed to tone before or after serums, but I put it on because it smells good. Okay, this best moisturizer in the world, Drunk Elephant, yet again, my favorite. It's like their retro whipped cream one. I've literally been through like 90 of these moisturizers. It is so good. It's like heavy enough to moisturize for the night, but it's like light enough to wear under your makeup. Guys, it's so good. I love it so much. Okay, guys, well, that's pretty much it.
I love you.
Oh, hi, come here. Now looking back, I don't want you guys to think that this video is sponsored, by the way. I just really, really stand by Drunk Elephant products. Away from the products, like, this brand is just so well thought out. Like, I read something, I think, about how, like the CEO or, like, the inventor of, like, Drunk Elephant as a brand, or she researches so much of, like, all the skincare products in the industry prior to Drunk Elephant, and she pretty much found these, like, I think it was, like, 6 common ingredients that a lot of people just react negatively to. But she thought, you know, how about we just make products that don't have any of the 6? I don't know what the 6 are. If I find it, I'll put it right here next to little Linky's head.
Oh, girl.
And then like their packaging, it's like closed off. Like you like twist it open, or like the face lotion you like pump open. Like nothing is a twist off and has an exposed product, because anything exposed to UV rays or oxygen or just several different things other than itself in the package can actually dilute the effectiveness of the product. I am a package whore. Like, you can literally sell me a box of dirt. If the packaging looks good, I will buy it. Like, I love packaging. That's a whole other video in itself. Whatever. I'm getting off topic, but yeah, Drunk Elephant is really good, and I know I didn't really explain in this, but my skin routine is exactly the same for day and night. The only thing I do change is the serum. For daytime, I use the vitamin C serum, which literally saved my life. Texture was the one thing that once I got past the breakouts, once I was able to tame my breakouts, I was like, I can't get past this like texture, and I just felt like I looked really dull. I just asked a Sephora person, and she was like, oh, you should definitely put vitamin C in your skincare routine.
Hi. Trying to put an album together by August 10th so that I can release it in August.
The tea. Don't forget to check out my merch. I will link it down below. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you next week. Bye.
You know where I go when we're dancing. Handshakes in the Hamptons and getting drunk in the mansions with you.